YouTube, what it do? It's your boy Young Mustard, and I'm back, you feel me, with the Q&A, end of the year Q&A. And to everybody that has supported me this year and all the other years, well, it's only been about a year and a half, but to everyone that supported this channel in general, I want to give a thanks to all of you guys, because without y'all, this would not be possible. But before we go any further, make sure y'all follow me on Twitter, follow me on social media. Those links will be down below. And before we get into the questions that people ask me and stuff, I want to start off with like a pre-surface, you feel me? And because a lot of people were giving me some similar questions, so I just thought I would just introduce myself for those kind of questions. My name is David. I am 18 years old. I'm in college. And for people who ask my in real life job, I don't have a technical job. I'm just a student. So yeah, that's where that is. I used to work at Walmart, you know what I'm saying, summer jobs. I have like occasional jobs that I worked at in the summer and things like that. But in terms of like a career, right now I'm still studying for law. I'm trying to go into law school, give you a little background there. And also my favorite team is the Chicago Bulls. And the other question that I saw very frequent is, what happened to my intro? Well, guys, let me just tell y'all this right now. My intro is gone, you know, and until I can find a way to work around it, and if I could bring it back, I would, but I can't right now, and I'm sorry, because they copyrighted it. They took it down, and I can't do nothing about that. I don't know why they just randomly took it out of the blue, but they just randomly started demonetizing my videos, and there was really nothing I could do about it, so I'm sorry, but I had to, you know, take care of that. But if I could bring it back, I will. And just to let y'all know, an intro is on the way. A new intro is on the way. I will try to bring it to you guys next year. The first video of next year, I will try to bring a new intro. But you guys, please stay tuned and bear with me. I'm sorry that the old intro is gone. Rest in peace. It was great, but there's really nothing I can do about that. And so without further ado, let's get on with this Q&A. Now, first, I'm going to take the Snapchat questions that I got, because I got a few questions on Snapchat. First question is from Andre, and he said, do you think Luka will become the best player in the league by the time LeBron retires? No, I do not, because I think Giannis will become the best player in the NBA when LeBron James is out of his prime. And I've talked about that in the video, so if you guys have not seen that, go check that out. And it's really just because of the fact that, look at the team he's on. The Bucks, they look like they're headed in the right direction now. They got a coach. Hopefully they get him another player, because I don't think he has another superstar on that team, or a potential superstar. As good as a lot of those other young players are, none of them have superstar potential, and he's the only superstar on that team. So I definitely think they should try to go get him another option. But yeah, as far as the best player, I don't think it'll be Luka Doncic. I definitely think it'll be Giannis Antetokounmpo. Now, the next question is from Ayomide from Snapchat as well. Shout out to him. He's Nigerian, just like me, you feel me? And his question was, do you think Kyrie will be the MVP this season? Simple, no, I do not think he'll be the MVP. I think that award will most likely go to either Giannis, Kawhi, or Steph Curry. Now, the next question is from Tommy on Snapchat, and he said, where do the Wizards go from here now that John Wall is done for the rest of the season? The reason I wanted to take this is because I made a video about John Wall and why they need to trade him, and why this season was very important for John Wall, and he's definitely failed all the expectations. The Wizards are trash. They're garbage. They are such a bottom feeder right now in the Eastern Conference, and I definitely think they need to trade John Wall, because if Bradley Beal leads this team to some type of positivity this year, that's when you know you need to get rid of John Wall. And it was a huge mistake to give him the contract that they gave him. But yeah, that's what they need to do moving forward. See what Bradley Beal can do this year, and after that, trade John Wall. Now, the next question is from Squill1IM. This is the YouTube questions now. And he said, who is the greatest Laker of all time and why? Magic Johnson is the greatest Laker of all time. To me, he is the third greatest player in NBA history. And why is because of the fact that he did so much in a short period of time. People don't even know. Magic did not even play that long due to obviously the AIDS scandal. And, well, not scandal, but the situation, I should say. And honestly, I definitely think because of what he did in that short period of time, and he quickly became the best player on that team. I mean, it was clear after like about the third, fourth year that Magic was the best player on that Lakers team. Don't get me wrong, Kareem was also great in his own right, but Magic straight out of the gates was phenomenal and great, and he just took the helm. He is arguably the greatest leader in the history of the NBA, and he showed leadership from the moment he stepped on the court, from his first NBA game. So I think Magic is the greatest Laker in NBA history. The next question is from Xavion Davis, and he said the best trade destination for Fultz as far as where he'll be the best fit. And he said to him, it's the Suns. I would think it's the Suns because they really have no option when it comes to that point guard spot. They've really been looking for a point guard for a long time. But I really don't know, because if the Suns don't get Zion, there's a chance that they're going to get another guard or another point guard. So I don't see that working out for Markelle Fultz, and he'll just be in the same situation as he was in Philly. And we all see how that's working out for him right now. So I don't think the Suns will work. Honestly, I don't know where he can go, because at this point in time, it looks like he's about to make his way out of the NBA sooner rather than later. And honestly, he's just going to join the list of top picks that had potential, but because of circumstances that he really couldn't control, it's tough, but it's going to just dictate his future. Now, the next question I got is from Will Rose, and he said, who would you rather have to start your franchise, Giannis or Anthony Davis? Now, right now, I'm going to take Giannis because of the fact that Anthony Davis, he is a big man, and I'm always more inclined to take ball handlers and forwards over big men anyway. And Giannis, I just love Giannis, you know what I'm saying? One of my favorite players to watch. And honestly, it's just a matter of time before he becomes the best player. But honestly, it's really close between them. And that could be the next rivalry, depending on where AD ends up. If he doesn't end up in Milwaukee, you know, wink, wink. But I definitely think that Giannis is who I would pick over Anthony Davis. And talent-wise, they're really neck and neck. And you could definitely argue AD, because of his circumstances, is that's the reason why he's not really brought up in a lot of the conversations among the elite players. I mean, he's brought up, but he's not really taken too serious because of his lack of success. But that's not really his fault. It's just a circumstance. But sometimes some players just can't control that. And it sucks, but that's life. Now, the next question is from Chicken Turds. And he said, why is everybody sleeping on Tobias Harris? Because he's on the Clippers. Let's just be real. Nobody ever cares about the Clippers until it's time to care about them. And when it's time to care about them, people still don't care about the Clippers. And that's why people are sleeping on Tobias Harris. But shout out to my boy Tobias, putting up all-star numbers. And hopefully, by God's grace, he'll be an all-star. Now, the next question is from Yeet Bix. And he said, who do you think is the most underrated or most underappreciated player of all time? Now, I really wanted to get into this question, so y'all bear with me here. Now, the most underrated and underappreciated, I think those are two different things. Underrated is someone who isn't given the credit for how great they are, or people just kind of sleep on how good they are. But underappreciated is more your contributions to the game. Well, this is my NBA definition. Your contributions to the game have kind of been overlooked, and people just underappreciate them, for lack of a better term. And honestly, I think when it comes to most underappreciated player, I would say Mark Price, because I definitely think he changed the game, especially how he used pick and rolls and split through them. Combine that with his shooting and you have Steph Curry right there. So I definitely think he has influenced the game in more ways than people can imagine. And a lot of people really just don't talk about that. And I don't know if it's because they don't care, or maybe it's because they don't know, or hell, maybe it's because he's white. I don't know. But Mark Price to me is the most underappreciated player in NBA history. Now, most underrated, I've said it once and I will say it 1,000 times till I'm dead. Chris Webber is the most underrated player in NBA history. And I think that's not even a debate, especially when you consider the fact that he's still not in the damn Hall of Fame. Especially when you consider the fact that you got guys like Reggie Miller, Yao Ming, Tracy McGrady, guys that did not even enjoy the level of success that he enjoyed in his career, especially with those early Sacramento Kings teams. With him and Stojakovic, that's another player that's underrated and slept on. But him, Stojakovic, Vlade Divac, all of them, Mike Bibby, they were a really solid team in the early 2000s who really pushed the Lakers, and just nobody wants to give him that credit that he deserves by putting him in the Hall of Fame. It's just ridiculous. To me, I think he's the most underrated player in NBA history. And sure, you got the other ones like Chauncey Billups and Ben Wallace and those other guys. But I definitely think that Chris Webber, without question, is the most underrated player in the history of the NBA. So Adam Silver, put that man in the Hall of Fame, because if you don't, actually, I'm not going to do nothing, but I'm still going to be pissed at you. And I'm not going to rock with you, because I actually like you as a person. But you got to get that shit together. Put Chris Webber in the Hall of Fame. Now, the next question is going to be a pretty controversial response, I'm pretty sure. And it's because he asked, who are my top five point guards? Now, he didn't say when or where, but I'm assuming you mean right now in the NBA, and that's the answer I'm going to give you. Right now in the NBA, I have Steph Curry number one. I think that's unanimous. Kyrie Irving number two. Mr. Clutch, Uncle Drew, all day number two. Number three, this is where it gets a little dicey. I have Russell Westbrook, but I definitely think because of this season, him and Dame are neck and neck. And the reason I say they're neck and neck is because Russ's inefficiencies have been god awful this year, especially from the three-point line. He just insists on shooting so many damn threes, and I appreciate the passion and effort that he puts into the game, especially on the defensive side of the ball, because he has definitely improved in that area. But Russ has got to get it together. He can't just be jacking up so many threes as if he's Steph Curry. And fourth, I have Damian Lillard, and the reason I have him fourth is because one, Chris Paul fell out of my top five, and Kemba Walker, I'm sorry, I can't put him in the top five either because of the fact that they're not winning. So I gotta put Dame up there in the top five. And fifth, I have Ben Simmons. So yeah, those are my top five point guards in the NBA today. Now the next question is from Mex Giova, and he said, have you ever met an NBA player? Now this is going to be a little story time, you feel me? And yeah, I have met only one NBA player in my whole life. And that actually happened last year when I was in college, because I was in the barber shop. And for those who don't know, my college is in San Antonio, UT San Antonio. You feel me? Go Runners all day. And I was just sitting down in the barber shop, me and my friends. And this guy, tall dude, just comes in and sits down. And I didn't even see when he sat down. And I'm just looking at the dude's face because he looked so familiar. And then I see him look up, he's talking to some kid, you know, he's just hanging out with some kid, messing around with him, playing around with him. And then I'm like, bruh, what the hell? I'm like, DeMarco, because that was my friend's name. I'm like, DeMarco, bruh, that's Danny Green. And he was like, dude, you're lying. Like, that's not no Danny Green, bro. Shut up. Like, stop joking. He was like, nah, Danny Green wouldn't be here. And I was like, bruh, look at his face. You know what I'm saying? And then he just stands up, and you know, my friend, she's next to me, she takes some pictures with him. She didn't even know who he was. It was me that pointed him out, and that's how she knew he was a famous person anyway. But she took some pictures with him. And then afterwards, I looked at some dude next to me because he saw that I was pointing towards him and I noticed him and all that. He was like, oh yeah, that's Danny Green. I was like, bro, what the fuck? I was so shook, not just because of the fact that I had met a celebrity or met a basketball player for that matter for the first time in my life, but just the way that he just came and just sat right next to us. And I was like, bro, that's crazy. You know what I'm saying? It's just crazy how you can just meet anybody, anywhere, any place, anytime, and your reaction is just going to be priceless when you see them for the first time, or just when you see any type of famous person for the first time. You know what I'm saying? It's just crazy. It was a cool experience. And yeah, that's the only time I've ever met an NBA player, and it was pretty cool. I'm not gonna lie, I'll never forget that moment at all. Now the last question is going to be the most controversial one, and I purposely saved it for last. It's from Alexander Atunes, and he said, Larry Bird or Kevin Durant? Now I'm assuming you meant Kevin Durant, but I'll let you slide there. But yeah, this is going to be pretty tough. Now when it comes to talent and greatness, those are two different things to me. So when it comes to the greatness perspective, I think we can all agree that Larry Bird is a top 10 player in NBA history, and I do have him higher than Kevin Durant on that perspective. But in the perspective of talent, I'm definitely taking Kevin Durant. And especially when you consider the fact that in this era, switching on pick and rolls are a big deal, and the lack of athleticism from Larry Bird, a lot of these players are going to take advantage of that, and sometimes that can make him a liability in certain situations. Now, I know Larry Bird was a really good defender back in the day, and I still think he can be a really solid defender nowadays because great players always find ways to adjust. But at the end of the day, athleticism is athleticism, and KD definitely beats him in that category. And when it comes to scoring, Larry Bird was a great scorer and very efficient from the three-point line, but he was attempting literally two threes a game. So calm down when it comes to the three-point efficiency. KD's out here attempting nearly six, sometimes five, you know what I'm saying? And his level of difficulty, you can have a hand in his face and he's still janking on you because he's 7 feet tall, so that just adds a whole nother dimension and element to his game, which also helps him on the defensive side of the ball. Like I said, he is a great rim protector. He has grown into that for this Golden State Warriors team. Now, as a passer and rebounder, I will give that to Larry Bird, and when it comes to clutchness, I would give that to Bird, but I think that's more intangibles when you're talking about clutchness and stuff like that. But even in the clutch, KD has shown over the past 2 to 3 years that he can be clutch. He has developed the clutch gene in Golden State, and he's become the closer, especially in those playoff situations and in the finals. So I think from a skill perspective, I'm going to take KD, but from greatness, of course, in the all-time scale, I'm definitely still going to take Larry Bird, as he is a top 10 player in NBA history. So that concludes this Q&A. Thank you so much for all the support that you guys have shown me this year. If someone told me last year that I'd be in this position so fast, I would have thought that they were just bullshitting me and trying to play me. But because of you guys, it was possible. So thank you guys for everything that y'all have done. Also, follow me on social media links. The links will be down below. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and the second channel. Those links also will be down below. So without further ado, to everybody that has supported me, I love y'all. And Happy New Year.